Thank you very much. Hi everyone, very happy to be here. So I will talk about spatial audio in Unity and basically run you through like use cases. So basically like field proven use cases and how we got there, how we got around, and which approach we took. Just for a bit of context, DRI, so yes, thank you Yann, we are like a creative art and technology studio, which means we have teams of engineers, artists, 3D artists, and we imagine experiences using like new technologies and art. I don't know if I have time to show you a bit of video, maybe not everything, but a tiny bit, it could be good. Let's do that. Didn't check the sound, but it's okay if you don't have sound. Yeah, I guess there's no sound through the video. But then I will talk a bit. So it's just to show like a few examples. So what we do is we build like either like some shows or interactive installations or performances, and basically everything you see is real time. So it happens in reality, on stage or in museums or exhibitions and everything. And we do use a lot of interactivity, and of course we use like video, audio, sometimes haptic device, like a bit everything. The idea is to have like immersive experiences where people can feel and experience something together, either being like actors or even being like in the audience. I just went a bit like through this. Yeah, I mean, you see there's lots of different kind of stuff, so a bit of robotics and video mappings and stuff like that. Sorry, I'm just going a bit quicker. Just so you know, like we have like different things going in the studio. So as artists, we do build and exhibit artwork, mainly on the New Media Art Festivals, and then we provide services for like a dance company, theater, opera, or brands, or cities. And those last years, we did a lot of, that's what we're going to talk about, immersive spaces. So immersive spaces, I mean like indoor spaces with a lot of video projections and interactivity. We're going to talk about it. So you can find them like in museums or showrooms or, I mean, different kind of caves also for research. And you also do science research on different kind of science directions. We did a lot of tracking, we did a bit of VFX in video game engine pipeline. And our last research work right now, mostly it's cognitive science in virtual reality, but it's something else. Okay, this is my bullshit slide. Let's get it here. So immersive spaces. So first, what is it? So I have like a bunch of photos. So this is all space, basically. Like, by the way, in Lyon, we do have an immersive space equipped with immersive sound and video interactivity. Maybe some of you did visit it. So this is just a few pictures of some stuff that can happen here. With what we do, all the artists who use it. So we do use like a lot of different kind of tools for video and audio. This is like how it looks like: video everywhere, sound everywhere, and interactivity. So just for the interactivity, quickly also, we use like Augmenta, which is like a tracking technology that we did actually create. That we do sell for people who want to add interactivity into immersive spaces or stage or any kind of project. Graham has some of those tech, and they do also like a digital lottery and some kind of other stuff with composers and music. So basically it's a network of free sensors, but if you want to track people on a space, you can put in the ceiling and then you receive all the tracking data, like speed, people, bounding box, everything you need, through OSC. I guess lots of people use OSC or WebSocket or any protocol through the network, and then you can receive it into Unity, Unreal, Max, any real-time tool, and then start doing stuff interactive. We do a lot of people tracking, but we also do like interactive surfaces like tables or walls, or even like interactive surfaces on the earth, so you can put your hands or something into like an earth touch surface, so to say. So now we're arriving into like what I want to show you. So we did like in different museums that you can find in France, like some in Paris, some in Champagne, some in Grenoble. There's like those immersive spaces with interactive sound and video that you could visit if you want, but we did deploy this year, I mean last year and this year. And we had to have different approach and constraints and challenges for the sound part and the spatial sound part. So that's what I want to talk about today. So basically, I just take this picture as an example. When you do an immersive space, you're gonna have like a maybe I can show you like a bit of video because you didn't see it like maybe live. Just to be sure we're all on the same page. This is a simple video like just to show you like when I say like interactive space is like somebody can walk in an immersive space. So here like he's touching the wall, but here you can see on the floor. The video is evolving with the people. So you can imagine, this is like just a little art immersive space kind of a prototype. That was like with a research lab in Germany, we did like this quick thing. But yeah, just to be sure. So that's what I call when I say like interactive immersive space. But when you want to do sound in here, then really quickly you're gonna think about like how do you specialize sound in such spaces. Because this one is quite small, but sometimes we do like really bigger space with lots of people interacting at the same time. Because there's no limit on the number of people we can track. So we could have like 100, 200 people, or just 5 or 10. And everybody is going to interact and move into the space. And if you want to have some sound with the people, or with the space, or in space, or if they do an action here, you want to have some here, you're going to have to really think about how you play sound, how you create sound, and how you specialize them in the space. And at the beginning it sounded simple, and finally actually it was not. So at the beginning we thought it would be simple because like we use most of the projects we do, we use Unity and sometimes Unreal now. And Unity and Unreal, like they do specialize sound like perceived, right? You have a 3D engine, you can have a sound here or a fountain here, and when you go close to the fountain, you have the sound of the fountain. So this is just like simple feature, a normal feature in video game engine. And nowadays we even have more, like with the VR and everything, sometimes you do have even like a binaural engine and everything, like we advanced to have some sound synthesis or reverbs, etc. with the 3D. So yes, there's a lot of things, but one thing they don't have is that everything you do with sound in a video game engine is everything thought to have at the end one listener in a sweet spot. So it can be stereo sound and you're hearing from the computer with stereo, or it can be headphones, it could be VR, etc. But everything you do is just for one person or several person in a sweet spot to listen. So it's really like a stereo approach. So it can be like really complicated to create all the sounds, etc. It can be specialized in the 3D world, but at the end of it, it's not specialized in the space, it's specialized just for one person to listen. And when you do this, and you want to specialize sound in the space, you quickly realize that Unity or Unreal are like, not done for that. So of course, there are tools done for that, like Max, etc., and the Spat plugin you can find. But maybe you did use, but they're not integrated at all in the 3D engine. And then when we had the challenge to specialize sound for like museums, etc., and different projects, the good aspect would be to have like, okay, Unity, Unreal are creating the visual aspect and interactivity, and then maybe you have like a Max engine or other real-time sound engine, and then maybe you have your objects in the 3D engine, and they will like send the coordinates where they are into Max, and Max will do the specializations and will maybe specialize the sound within the different speakers that you have. But this can work, but it's a bit complicated because like every time you want to have some sound space, you have to send the coordinates, etc., and the workflow also is not so nice. And also sometimes like the tech company that deploys the space in the museum, they don't want to pay like a Max license, etc. So there's lots of field constraints that make it not Yes, not so easy to have this approach. So you have to find something to make it work into Unity. Okay, I don't have so much time. So this, for example, was like one project. So in this project, we had like 6 and 8 speakers on the ceiling, and they were all like facing like up or down like that. So they were all the ceiling, and we had like 2 subs and 6 speakers on the ceiling. And so we wanted to have people going into the space, and when people move into the space, we wanted to have like some ambient sounds everywhere, so in all the speakers, but also some sounds going with the people in the space. Because like we had like some visuals going with the people, and we wanted to have like a sound. So when they walk, there's some sound. When they don't move, there's no sound. But when you have like 5, 6, 7, 8 people, then you could, if you don't specialize it, there will be just like too much sound, right? If you have 10 people, there's one sound for each people everywhere. It's just not possible. So you want to have one sound for each person, and if I'm here, you want to have sounds over here, and the other person who is here, you want to have sounds over here, right? So how do we do this? So you want to have like those sounds around the speakers in the correct specialization and with a good specialization. And so what we ended up doing is like, first thing, we had to find a way with Unity to have like easily sound going into like the 8 channels for first thing to do. And this is not easy with Unity to say, okay, you want to have like some sound going into speaker number 5, some sound going speaker number 2, etc. This is not easy for technical reasons in the engine. So we could find a way with some assets that you can find in the Unity Asset Store, which is called AudioStream. And they can actually do that, and you can do exactly what you want in a different channel, and you can also play sound in all the channels. So they have a... But actually, really recently, they did it last year, really in a way that we could do what you wanted to do. So this is okay. And the second thing is, how do you specialize that? Because there's no really, I mean, to my knowledge at least, there's no specialization plugin in Unity to do such things. To say, okay, my speakers are here in space, and I want to have sound when I have an object here, etc. So we built ourselves, finally. This was the easiest way. So we took like just a very naive approach. And our next approach is really simple, is like we place all the speakers in Unity in our 3D world, because we have the 3D world simulation for all the visual work and interactivity work. So we have like the meadows and everything modelized. And then each speaker would be like kind of a sphere, which acts kind of a virtual microphone. And when somebody enters into this sphere, then we just like have volume increasing with the sound. And when you go out of the sphere, the other sphere catches you and you have a volume increasing, and just with volumes and sounds moving, we could have specialization that was good enough for what we wanted to do. And so we could have like an ambience within all the speakers plus sounds attached to physical people or to virtual objects also, which could be, that would work. So that's how we did. And yeah, and all those right things was just to show that we had like 6 speakers a bit like that and 2 subs a bit this way. Really, this was the Unity assets, by the way, which is mostly for streaming and everything, but that was the one who... I think they did replace totally like the audio engine in Unity, and then you go through that, and then you can do actually what you want. Super quickly, because I think I'm out of time, there's another use case we had recently. Recently, it's actually like one space, immersive space, that will open in Grenoble probably next year, with a huge immersive space, like 12 meters by 6 for like a screen and floor. And everything is also interactive. And in this case, it shows you have like more like a standard setup, so 5.0 setup. So like 5.0 setup, like cinema setup, right? Like so 2 speakers in the rear, 1 center, 2 speakers front, and 1 sub. Center, left, right. And so in this case, then we could have 5.1, typical soundtrack, the same way you do for cinema. So like an artist could build like a soundtrack, but we wanted to play that on the speakers, and we wanted also to do those interactive sounds. This use case is this actually, like this is one of the stage of development of one of the content we do, which is kind of a game when you have to avoid asteroids going through you. It's a game. Maybe I have like a small video of it. This is the end time. Good. Almost finished. Just so you can imagine a bit. So everybody's trapped, as you can see, and you have kind of bonus and powers, and you have those asteroids coming towards you. We don't see it so much. You have those asteroids coming towards you, and you have to avoid them, and you have to run the space. And the game is designed to play on a much bigger space, which is just our studio where we do Prototype. But basically, when you do this, those asteroids that come, you want to have a sound, right? You want to have the asteroids coming towards you, and they go like, whew, and they go from front to rear. And also, of course, it's a game, so there's like a lot of different sounds happening also in the game, plus the soundtrack, which is also like have to be massive. And what we could do here is we could like play the ambient sound in a 5.1 standard way. Plus, on top of that, mixing it with like the sounds, with same technique I explained before. So basically, in Unity, we have like a sound attached to the asteroids, and the sounds go through, and we put the speakers everywhere in space, and then we have this effect working. That's it. That was my two use cases I wanted to share on how we could manage to have a special sound into Unity with finally a very naive approach. Thank you very much.